and I'm back with Mike's daily training. Let's have some entertaining games, let's have fun, and let's go! Great. Let's go. Let's see a game, I don't know, between Grandmaster Equelmer 93 and Grandmaster Dmitry I am. Good. Interesting player, Requel me is in a huge time trouble. Ooh! Ooh! What a trip! Queen G3 would have been made. We'll win it! Wow! Dmitry him at 3 extra seconds. A queen for a bishop and he lost. Insane! Okay. Okay, so in this game it seems like Requelmer is a pawn up and it seems like he's better. I think knight f6 is the idea, though this bishop h6. Oh, bishop h6. Bishop h6 is possible, isn't it? No. I mean, maybe it was possible, but Dmitry I didn't want to play it. I would have taken queen g4, but I'm not a GM. Yet. Yeah. H6, oh well, knight seems fine-ish, not so fine-ish. Uh-oh, pawns will go for Requelmer. Yeah. GG. That was a close one. But it felt like Requelmer was winning like from the beginning. Din and mate on G4. Okay, this knight f6. Looking very interesting, you know. Unusual way to play, but very interesting. This. Oh, knight f2! What a blunder by Requelmer. Knight g4 now. And now Dmitry I am is. After knight 3 would be a pawn up. Yep. He is a pawn up. It seems. Very good for him, for Dmitry I am. Oh, whoa, okay, it's not a blunder, but it felt close. Gtxc would be a blunder because queen b2 mate. Gtxc, Dmitry I am, is 2 points up. King g7, knight e6, so yeah, queen e7. I mean, I have 7 pawn hangs, so I'm not sure. Ooh, rook e2. Okay, Dmitry, I am 1. So it's some ultra bullet. Grandmaster Mastaktika Teoria from. Against. Anar Dr. Stein. Okie dokie. Ooh, that was close. finally got an opening playing NohutluPilavv. He's from Netherlands. Hello, good luck. Dordrecht, Netherlands. Good luck. His speed rating of 1967. Good luck. Oh, he does take, so it is going to be exchanged queen, accepted queen's gambit, I think. Castle d4. Okay. Rook e1. All right. Okay. Takes, takes. Let's play a3. D5 maybe is the idea. Okay. This, I think I may consider d5. I know, maybe it's not good, but I think I am going to play it. Knight d5. Alright. Maybe not the most aggressive play, but pretty comfy, I guess. This bishop takes d5. I think bishop e6 may be a mistake, because basically now this queen d1, bishop f7 will be a pawn up. D5 f takes c. I'll have a better pawn structure. So here bishop f7. He maybe messed it up. Or maybe I've messed something up for in future. Okay. Mm-hmm, alrighty. Rook d8, I'm going to take on d8. Maybe bishop g5, I'm not sure. I guess his idea is bishop f6. True. Maybe I can try like b4? Bishop f6, rook a2. Yeah, let's try b4. Mm-hmm. Okay. Looking fine. Yeah, looking actually good. Because I'm a pawn up. Nice. Okay. Okay. Alright, he thinks a5. Whoa! I think that may be a little mistake. I'm not sure. Just thinking aloud. B5, bishop f6 is maybe the move he is going to go for. Yeah, maybe I can go for bishop d2. I can take, but I think I'm going to go for b5. Yeah, he does go for bishop f6. Oh well. Oh well. Yeah, I think I don't have enormous advantage, but the head position is pretty good. Let's play rook b1. Mm-hmm. Okay. Oh, that's actually a spicy move. I was like, wait, what? He just gives away a knight? But then I was like, ah, of course he does give the knight if I will blunder mate. And I didn't really want to do it, so I think he does not give the knight away then. Bishop e3. I mean, bishop d2. Bishop e2 doesn't feel good. I mean, it is fine, but bishop e3 seems trappy, and knight d4 takes bishop rook d1. So let's go for bishop e3. He can go for knight e5, but I think he should be fine there also. Okay. Okay. All right. Interesting. What is going to go for? I think knight e5 is the move which seems most likely, but I'm not sure. Oh well. He still sings. Alrighty. Knight e7. Interesting. Nice move, I think. Though I think I'm going to go for a4, fixing his a5 pawn. Yeah, that it's a bit more of a weakness. Let's say bishop b6. Nice play from NohutluPilavv. g5 rook f3, it's not good. Oh, knight d2, look at that, and then knight c4. That's an interesting idea. Oh yes, rook a3, and I'm not sure if it's good. This is going to be pretty hard to win, I think. Bishop here. I think if he'll play rook a3, I'm going to go for this. And bishop d8. And maybe give away a bishop for a knight. But not sure about the sin giving away bishop for a knight. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, he does go for rook a3, takes on a5. Now bishop d8. Yeah, but why not bishop b4? Because now if he moves knight from e7, then I have bishop f6. I think he may go for knight d5, but I'm not sure. I was thinking he'll go for knight e5, and then he went completely different move. Of course, so yeah. Okay, this, maybe I'll just play g3 to get some room for my king. Hmm. this. Okay. I'm going to take. Okay. Well, I think in g2 is a nice move if he's going to go for knight d4. I may or take on d4 or play something else. Or knight d2, I think. Or even something else like rook d1. Something like this. I think idea can be h4 and then Ag5, maybe. Okay, nice idea from him. I cannot play. I mean, I can play h4, but then he left knight e3, which I think may be a bit annoying, to be honest. Well, let's play king f1. He'll go rook a4, I mean, maybe it's not the best, but still, I got some progress at least. Yeah. If rook a4, I think I may go for h4. Knight e6. Alright, I think he said he has knight e4 probably. Rook b4. Let's try. Here, king g2. Okay, this. Yeah, because I just want to say rook a2 would not give much to him there. So, yeah. Understandable why he went for b6. Let's just give a check. And check where he'll go. Okay, he goes to e7. Go knight d4, I'm not sure. Maybe I need knight g5 actually. But there he had h6, so I'm not so sure if it would have been correct or not. h5 by him has been played. Alright, I guess I can go for this. Let's go h4 and then maybe knight f5. Okay, he goes for g6.
Knight f3, knight e5, maybe.
Let's go knight f3. I don't mind giving away b5 pawn, because if I will take all those two pawns, I'll be two pawns up. And it is much easier to promote three pawns together when there is just one pawn alone. So he goes for rook a8. I'm going to go for knight e5. This. Knight f3, knight b5, rook b4. Yeah, I'm just a bit struggling to find win. I didn't want to allow him play g5, that's why I play knight f3 basically. Yeah. Okay. here. I mean, knight b5, I think, isn't the idea still. So, yeah. Let's try rook d4. Just to make a move, to be honest. Yeah, let's try rook d. Oh no! Yeah. I want knight d4 or rook e1, knight e5, but I didn't see that he has knight b5. Oh well, I guess I have rook e1 there. Let's play. No draw, I have a pawn up. Maybe I cannot break through, but. Wow. Why a draw? Knight e4. King here. I mean, the opposition is equal, I know, but I'm still a pawn up. So usually it's not the thing you want when you're a pawn up. Rook b1. Okay, that's interesting. Oh, I want king f3. That would have been an oopsie. I don't know. B3 here. So I still cannot go for king f3. True. Knight 6. Maybe if knight d6, I mean I have knight a7. Which maybe I won't go for. Rook f3 check. Eh, your ranks. True. Alright, let's go for knight a7. That's the best place for my knight, to be honest. But fine. I need to put it there, I think. F3, maybe g4 ideas? Trying something, at least. Here. D3. King h3 and then g4. Yes. This. G7. Oh. Oopsie! Oh well, rook b7. Pawn for a pawn. Fair trade, I guess. It's gonna hit c6. Yeah, checks. Yes, checks. Run! Let's run away from the checks. Stop! Oh no. Oh yikes. Oi. Sure, where's the win? Thanks. Whew, I don't want to name NohutluPilavv. He's from Netherlands. Good game, thank you. He's from Dordrecht, Netherlands. He has federation of 1967. Good game. Yeah, I think it was draw, but then he blundered. I mean, maybe I was better, but I think it was really hard to win if I was better. Maybe I just wasn't. No one knows. Yeah, it was equal. So, that would have been hard to win, you know? I mean, I was better, but 2-1-0. And a mistake at 40th move and for a blunder there. Okay, that was a pretty close fight, you know? Okay, what do we have here? Rook c2. Yeah, so basically rook c2. Takes my queen, I have rook c8. He takes my rook, I have queen b8. Oh, that's plus 12. Cool. Yeah, basically, now that's important, and queen c7, and he just can't run away. I've had this puzzle, I think, several times. This queen g6. No, wait! It's not g6. Queen g6, it's knight g6. It's actually knight g6, not queen g6. Yikes. I think I like this, you know, rook b6 is pretty interesting. Yeah, bishop c4. Oh, knight. Rook. I'm confused. What is better? I'm not sure. Like bishop b5? Nice. Nice! 2200 rating in tactics. I think it's kini 2 in between, or no? No, kini 2 it takes. Hold on, yeah, it's not rook f5 immediately. I know it. I rook d3, right? Something like this. Yeah, so basically rook d3, if he takes one and f7, I have rook h3 check. Bog. Bog. Okay, let's continue. I think knight g3 is looking extremely good. Stunningly good. Queen e3, f takes e, this. Yes. Yep, nice! Let's go! Oh, really, training limit is over. Okay, nice. Pretty good solving. Plus 37, let's go! So nice game against Nohutlu. 2-1-0 for me, 2-0-1 for him. So yeah, that was so equal. He just hung a pawn. And it was so equal. I mean, yeah, I tried my best. Knight d4 was a mistake. I had to go for knight g5, king e7, like rook e1, knight e6. So, no, king d7, rook e6. This rook g6, near and better. Makes sense, yeah, then it was equal for a while. And a g3 blunder, he had to go for rook d1 check, and it would be a draw. And rook g3, and he gave up an on rim NohutluPilavv. Good game. Boom, boom. Boom. Yeah, basically, almost everything would work. Nice. Okay, so I think this analysis, I mean, 73 moves, but it is going to be pretty quick because there was nothing blunderful. I mean, yeah, just one mistake from me, one from him. So it was equal, more or less. This bishop, bishop e6 was, well, let's say, straight to analyze with Elfrizio. Ah, wait. Boom. Bada boom. Nice. Yeah, so bishop e6. Oh, on freeze is actually easy best move. Oh no, bishop f6. They are fine. Yeah, because I didn't have super many. I mean, I have a pawn, but he has extremely great compensation for that pawn. So, yeah, I tried to realize it, but I did not manage to. Here, rook 8 would be a draw. True. But these. Actually, on freeze, I did not make a mistake even here. Yeah, I think that usually was the only inaccuracy. I mean, maybe there were some inaccuracies. Oh, yeah, so basically here I thought like, oh no. Yeah, he need knight g3. Knight g3 would have been slightly better, probably. Here, I was surprised that he didn't go for f4 pawn, and I had my king in the center. Here it is equal, but knight g3 is a blunder from him. He just had to go for 4. Rook b5, for example. King e4, knight d6, and draw. And here, open resign, one dream, NohutluPilavv. He's from Netherlands. Good game. Today is going to be something interesting. I can already inform you that it is going to be something cool. Ta-da-da-da-dun. 204 games, that's cool. Alright, so. I mean, now use the usual stuff. Let's play in slot 22 with black, probably. Yeah. Let's play c5. a6. Bishop b4. Yeah, this. Let's go for knight c6. Castle. e5. Oh, I am not sure about this. Let's have fun. I think it may be a mistake. We'll see. Yeah, because I'm always not a fan of playing with pawns like that. But wait, that's just a fun game against a computer. Why can't I try it? I mean, definitely can. Bishop f5? No. Okay, here I think I'm going to take with queen. Probably go rook d1. Yeah, he does. Queen b6. Hold on, maybe I blundered. Maybe I did. Maybe I didn't. Yikes, yeah, rook d7. Tutorial allowed to lose in one move. Well, I still didn't lose. But so much pressure. Okay, I'm not sure. Let's play queen d6. Yeah, maybe I'm not lost, but surely I'm not better. Let's try this. Is queen e1. Ah, just that. My nose is so itchy. Not extremely great game. Yeah, queen b6 was a mistake. I need something more safe, let's say. Okay, bishop f8. Queen e8 here. And last game, Grandmaster level 22. Yeah. Thanks for saying that. Yeah, 92. Okay, for him, 81.1 for me. I think you can see the moves. I think I won't say them. So yeah, it was basically all perfect. Just perfection. I don't know, what else can stop pitching. Can I cheat threat winning material? Queen b6? Yeah, I needed queen b6 now. I mean, still, it was pretty good. And queen b6, a blunder, trade piece, just bishop g4. Yeah, and then basically, because here, rook d7, I'm completely lost. So, plus 5.7 and 80. Oh, hold on. Can't stop checkmate. Okay. So, plus 8 and 89.1 in total. Alrighty, so ready to play against master, also black. Interesting. Let's play e6. Think it's going to be Rogozin. Pretty much. I'm not sure. I think it's unusual to take on c3 in these variations, but I will. You can't stop me. And h6. I think b6. Okay, c takes d and then bishop b7. Yeah, looking pretty good. Rook a c8. King h8. Now bishop a8. I think knight e7 is interesting. It's threatening c3 pawn. Now here. Let's play. Rook fc8. Ah, nice play. Oh, that is interesting. I maybe need my kid on g8 so I can play like queen f5 or something like this. Whoa, that actually looks scary. You know? Quite scary. So just doing it. No? Yeah, I knew it. It won't be a draw. That simple. I can try b5 and like a6. B5 knight d5 idea. Cause yeah, I wanted to play knight d5, but it prevents me because I mean technically he did nothing, but I cannot really go for it because he would have had c4. Yeah. Let's play queen e7. Rook c1. Yeah. Seven pressure. Just a bit annoying, to be honest. Okay, let's take. No pawn take. Nice. I think that it's not a pawn take is very, very nice point. Queen a6. Though, I'm not sure. I mean, my knight is very good, I think. Still have to not blunder. Let's try my best to not blunder. Maybe a5 fixing this pawn, though you can play rook b5. I'm not sure. D6 looks weird. Rook b8, yes, rook b5. I'm not sure if I really want it. Queen b4. Maybe queen b4. C8. Let's try it. C6. Queen b7. h5? I mean, I think shouldn't be bad. Basically, if you'll go knight e5, queen b4. Ah, he attacks my pawn. Yes, I can go for g6. Yep. Pretty much. Ah, this. Queen e7. It's 3 rook b7, I'm not sure. Let's try knight c3. Queen b4, yeah. Makes sense. I also thought that he's going to go for it at some point. Well, I need it.
I can use computer moves.
Cool. I think I'm going to take. I can prevent rook b7, I'm pretty sure. I think I can play like a5, rook c4, knight d5, and if rook b7, there is rook f8. Ta-dan. I'm not sure if it's so good. A5, rook b7, rook f8, and I can take on a4. That looks cool. I don't know why I didn't see it immediately, you know. Oh, well. Steel knight d5, knight b6 ideas. Knight b6, yes, rook c7. No! The f rook f8. Yahoo! Okay, knight b6. Rook f8. Knight here. Knight b6, and just a blockade knight. On d5. Oh no. No. Let's not do it. Rook d8, he'll go rook a7, I'll go rook f8. Here, go rook d8. I'm fine with the draw. As you can see, I think. He's not so fine. He wants to win. Yeah. Okay. I guess I can just go on the, like, knight f6, knight d5, knight f6, knight d5. Yeah, why not? You may play knight d7 at some point, I think. I hope. This. And basically knight d5. Is he going to break soon? Let's see if we check. Go back to d5. Check. Oh dear, that's aggressive. Rook c7? Or just rook f8? And I think he shouldn't break through. But I think maybe rook c7? It's just to be sure. Though I'm not sure if it'll be good. Okay, I mean knight f6, knight e4, or knight c3, knight e2. Ideas. Oh! Whoa! Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. That's an interesting play from level 21 master. I think I may just go king f8, prevent everything. Here, I mean king e8, why not? Go king d8, pretty much, I think. Should be fine. Yeah, now king e7. Oof! Knight e2, g4, knight d4. And knight e2. Knight e4. I can try f5, I think. I'm not sure if I want to do it. Knight g1. Yeah, knight g5 is quite annoying. I'm a bit worried that he'll push g4, you know. Think I may be just worried of nothing. But I am. Nothing you can do about it, I guess. Oh, knight g1. Okay, knight e2. Just repeat, please. Thank you. once more. No, king e3. He's a bit trolly. I think I may just like go hg, gf5. Should be good. Yeah, this. King d6, or knight b3. King d6, or knight b3. King d6, or knight b3. Let's go king d6. Or knight b3. Okay, king d6. Oh no, that's scary. It will be very funny if I lose this, you know? It will be very, very funny, but I guess not for me. Okay, king f6. I think king e5 should be fine. Knight g6, king d5, king f4. I don't think it will be fine anymore. Maybe. Wait, I am confused. Knight b3, preventing king d4. And like d6, I play knight c5. If king d4, go knight e6. I'm not sure, I'm going to go for it. Oh, here. G5, you'll have SpongeBob. Oi, oi, oi. Knight here. Knight e6. I guess here g5 is a good chance. Hg, he won't do it. Knight h5. Yeah, let's go g5. I'm scared even more now. I mean, I think my knight should be a hero. I hope so, at least. Knight c5, knight d8, is a blunder, and knight d6 is a blunder. So sure, it will be good. King g4, he goes knight e6. No, he goes knight g2. I think knight g2, king. Maybe f3, knight g3. I'm not sure. Let's repeat. Oh. That was so sweaty game. I don't know why. I think it was like draw all the time. But it felt pretty hard. End of the game, level 21. Good game. And 95.7 for him, 95.9 for me. Yeah, it was slightly better than it was a complete draw. But I don't know why I felt I was lost at some point. Yeah, I think trade pieces. Pawns, you meant to say, right? Okay, knight 7 is a mistake. Might cause trouble. Knight a5? Not much, but doesn't help. Either rook fd8. Not helpful moves, that's all. What did I just say? I can't even repeat. Oh, I'm not so sure what is good, actually. Ooh la la, g6? I mean, that seems like a helpful move, you know? Might cause some trouble, rook 7. Okay, that's helpful. Rook c8, inaccuracy. Really not helpful moves. Okay, queen f5, I just need to try to trade queens off immediately. Then here I made a bit of an oopsie g6 mistake. Now I'm worse. Knight f6 maybe? No, might cost something. And this way I think is really costly. Yep, this loses a piece. Hmm.
it's a piece. I think that's a pawn.
Para, 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 bam. Is there any that goes in trouble moves? I hope there is at least one. Oi, I am not sure. F6! Another move which causes some trouble. Oh, this is actually a big advantage for him. Yikes. Knight b6. I don't know. Now that's it. Worse. Yes, knight c6. Fork. No, don't fork my pieces. They're just way too good to get forked. I mean, my pony's under attack. And when I try to save my pony, it says no, it causes more trouble. Help me. I don't know. I'm going to try everything. If before I thought, now I'm going to go crazy. Okay, I'm not sure it was taken off on file. Okay, I'm sure it was a good move, but okay. Winning before is a great move. Only good move. Yeah, that's pretty understandable why it is a good move only. Here I was a bit like worried that his skin went for a huge walk. And then this, I mean, it felt no problems, but I did felt some problems at the same time. Yeah, here king f6 and g5, and then after he played knight f4, g5 is a breakthrough, and plus 2.2 and 98.1 accuracy in total. And the cool scene is that I'm going to analyze 3 games from World Championship match. Let's get right into the first game. Alright. Let's go. First game where Nepo was white and Magnus was black. It was Rylopus. Pretty interesting variation. So, yeah, knight a5, Magnus gave away a pawn. But bishop b7, d3, d5, he gave away a pawn. But he has 2 bishop advantage. So, yeah, mate threat, but of course Nepo does not blunder mate, he plays queen f3. Then bishop d6, king f1, rook f8, queen d5, knight d5. Here position is equal, though it feels like, and even Stockfish says, it is slightly better for Nepo because he has a pawn up, of course. But Magnus has some compensation, like knight b4 ideas, basically see rook e8 maybe, yeah, rook e8, or knight b4, we said draw. Okay, bishop d2, c5, knight f3, knight c3, and yeah, bishop f4 inaccuracy, Nepo to go for knight g3, because here, after bishop f4, Magnus took on f3, g takes f, takes, even though Nepo is a pawn up, he has 2 doubled pawns, so you can't really get use of them. Oops. Yeah, he can get use of them. So rook c6, king f8 was inaccuracy from Magnus, he had to go for g6. Then rook f6, win f3 pawn, and position would have been equal. But yeah, maybe Magnus would have win a pawn, and as you can see, he's even slightly better. Knight e1 is an exit from Nepo, he had to go for king e2, protecting the weak d3 pawn in this way. So this, knight g7, rook e4, that. So yeah, Magnus has much more space for the compensation for the pawn. So king e2, rook b8, capture, now takes, knight's equal, position on pawns, knight e3, Magnus plays rook d7, Nepo plays knight c4 with a threat of fork, Magnus doesn't want to get forked, he plays rook e7, Nepo plays knight e5, attacks the rook, then rook d6, knight c4, Rook c6, knight e5. Rook d6 and knight c4 in threefold repetition. That is how the first game had ended. That was a pretty interesting game where Magnus was a pawn down, but he had a very, very good compensation actually for that pawn. And he managed to get the pawn back and draw the game. Second game was very interesting, in my opinion, where Magnus also gave away a pawn. So, it was, could have been Catalan if Magnus played knight e5, but yeah, I think Catalan would be, Catalan is usually an equal position, so Magnus wanted something more aggressive, and he played queen c2. Nepo doesn't want to give away c4 pawn, so Nepo plays b5, Magnus plays knight e5, threatening the rook, and yeah. C6, A4, Knight D5, Knight 3 is an accuracy. Magnus had to take, takes, Knight C3, F6, then Queen E4 is a great move. Queen E4, look at that. If F takes E, Knight D5, E takes D, takes, 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 Bishop 8, Magnus is just an exchange up and completely win position. So that wouldn't be good for Nepo, so Nepo had to play after Queen E4, Knight B6, Knight G4 there. If f5, oops, that's mostly. If f5, Magnus would have only moved queen e5, bishop d6, and beautiful move, bishop to g5. Then queen d7, queen b5. Position is really unclear. Magnus would have a rook for two pieces, but at the end it would have been equal. So yeah, but probably not amazing for Magnus. That's why he went for knight c3. Knight e3 was an exit from Nepo, he had to go for knight a to c6, then d5, breaking through in the center, then in this position, variation ends. Yeah, because basically g takes f. Rook c1, Magnus is a pawn down, but c4 pawn hangs, and at the end I think it should have been very good. Knight e5, Magnus had to go for knight f6, takes bishop h6, knight e1. It says Magnus is slightly better because Nepo's king is very vulnerable, but I would like to play a Nepo because it feels like knight on d3 just makes Magnus' position so much more passive. And yeah, even though Stockfish says Magnus is plus 0.4, I would probably choose to play a Nepo. But Magnus played knight e5 instead of knight f6. Rook b1 is an exit, Magnus had to go for bishop e3 and give away a change in that way. If Nepo would play knight e5 here, there is knight b7, takes, then bishop d4 with queen e6 ideas. Near a very cool position, Magnus is an exchange and two pawns down, but position is equal because here he gets the pawn back. Now, oops, he gets another pawn back, then they trade queens, then bishop g2, third pawn would go back, and two bishops are very strong in pair together with rook. Another continuation after knight e5 would be bishop c5, then knight d3, knight b7, queen b7, bishop f8, king f8, queen e6, this, queen c6. And here Magnus would be even a pawn up, but for a very, very short moment, Nepo would take a pawn and that would be a very equal position. Knight bc1 was played in the game after rook b1. This, Magnus is an exchange and a pawn down, but Magnus has so cool position because Nepo bishop, look at that. Nepo's bishop is looking, yeah, basically there is five pawns of the same color as bishop. So Nepo's bishop is very not good. Here Nepo played c3, it was an exit. He just had to take a pawn. Then Magnus would have to play bishop h7, this, rook d4, queen e7. And probably if Nepo would have found it, it would be really interesting to play. Nepo has two rooks and a pawn for a queen. Position is equal. Even though Nepo doesn't have a very, very good bishop, he has two very active rooks and a passer which gets eaten. But that position would have been a very interesting position, actually. But it was played in the game. C3, Queen c2, and b takes c was the next e when Nepo lost his advantage fully. The position is completely equal, as you can see right here. So yeah, queen g7, f4 would have been the best move for Nepo. This queen h3, and position is very unclear. Even though Magnus is an exchange down, he has a very scary passer. Kings are very not good for bows, so best line is this, and play that e7, rook g8, rook f1, and here position is just very interesting. But after b takes a, which was played in the game, queen e4, rook fd8, and yeah, now Magnus is an exchange down, but he gets a pawn back. And now position is completely equal. Here Nepo decides to finally give away an exchange back. c5, Magnus wins a pawn. But in rook endgame it is completely equal. He tries to give away his pawn on h5 and plays g5. But there is no way he can break through. And a draw, very intense and interesting second game. But yeah, in a big fight it ended in a draw. And now let's analyze so far final game, round number 3. I think so far it was less, one of the most, let's say, less aggressive games. So it was the same line like in game number 1. Wait a second, a4. Yeah, Jan decides to play a4, I think. So you can see in game number 1, it was h3 here. So yeah. Nepo decides to go for something different, a4, bishop b7, d3, position is very equal, no one has anything, knight c4 here, knight c6, rook c1, a5, bishop c3, yeah, here I would probably, if someone would say with whom you would like to play, I would say I would like to play with Nepo, with white pieces, basically, yeah, because a5 pawn is technically can be a weakness at some point. You can play d4, which Nepo did play in the game. And yeah, d4, this, bishop e6, h3, c6, bishop c2. Magnus was technically forced to play c6, d5 here. And that's what he did. Nepo played e5, d takes c, takes, e takes f, bishop b4. Takes another pawn, Magnus is technically forced to take the bishop if he wants to take the pawn back, though it wasn't really needed. He could have just played rook b8, and this pawn is not really making any pressure at all. So Stockfish is a very cool line. Bishop f6, bishop e1, rook e1, rook d2, rook c1, and here Nepo would be an exchange down. But yet, he would have a pawn for that exchange. Look at that, Magnus' king cannot move. G7 pawn may have been scary. So that's definitely a nice move for Magnus, because I think he doesn't want any extra problems. Then they traded one pair of rooks, they trade another pair of rooks, f5, f4. Magnus has closed the position, and yeah, this, h4, and they started repeating. And here a draw. So yeah, this in my opinion was by far less not most aggressive game. So far in the match it is 3-1.5 to 1.5. 3 games has been played. So today was a rest day, and tomorrow is going to be an interesting day where it will be round 4 and Magnus is going to be with white pieces. See you later in the review. And yeah, that's cool. Yeah, so looks very nice. I liked the game number 2, I think, by much more, because it was a bit more aggressive. Yeah, I like this position where Magnus is an exchange and a pawn down, but he's fine. And yeah, that was very cool. So, I hope you like this little twist in the stream. Yeah, so hope you like the stream. If you did, then please join me on chat, PeshkaCh Club. My team is around 980 members, including very, very much. So 20 more members, and I will make tournament 1,000 members. At least I will be very happy. And also, please join my club at home, Tykhon Fun Club. I'm in club 0164 members. Thank you all very, very much. So 36 more members until my tournament 200 members. At least I will be very happy. And thank you for following on the chat, on YouTube, and on Twitch. And as usual, please hit the button and subscribe to me, and please consider and please join chess, club.com, and also please join my Discord. If you join my Discord, you'll get notifications when I stream on Twitch and when I post videos on YouTube. Link in the description. And yeah, bye bye. Пока-пока. See you soon. See you tomorrow. Same fun. See you all. Say cool.